we have here is the styling model underneath this gigantic plaster mold. We're going to use this mold. We're going to break it tomorrow, actually. You also see this steel cage, and what that's for is to actually use as guides for when we construct the final prototype, when the final body parts come. They'll use these guides to help position the body panels on the final car.
First, this is very, very exciting because immediately arriving Stile Bertone, making a supercar, and these are two words that definitely go hand in hand, Bertone and supercars. And doing something that is more than just a physical show car, that is actually going to hit the road and impress people. I think the innovation, of course, is a very unique design. It has nothing to do with some recooked design. In that case, I think the overall appearance, for sure, it's very new. It's very, very new, very unique, but mostly very daring. And I think that's the coolest thing about it. It's very, very daring. This was, of course, Jason's direction from scratch. He wanted to produce a design that is as extreme as possible, because he's just not afraid and try to push the border and push the edge.
Well, I think the thing about Jason is that he is a real student of design, meaning he will look at Bertone's history, which of course is the very angular, in your face, nasty in a good way type design. And he will use that history to come up with something that is absolutely modern, stands on its own, and is really gonna be very exciting.
What about like the interior?
This is gonna be like a race car. Right. This is gonna be pure, it's gonna be, maybe a bit crude. It's gonna be carbon fiber, it's gonna be lightweight, it's gonna be Spartan. It's going to be the minimal of what you need. But, I have the intention of putting in a digital racing display, something that you see like in the FXX, for instance. The door panels will be bare carbon fiber. The roof and the side glass is polycarbonate, so that's also...
Is that going to be one piece like the P45 or no?
It's very similar to P45 treatment in that, you'll see an upper glazing area, the transparency area. It'll have a glass windscreen. This, unlike P45, actually has roll-down windows, but then the rest of the area will be polycarbonate or Lexan, so it'll be very lightweight. And today, the design process has really shifted, in terms of when I started 8-9 years ago, we were talking about doing 80% manual physical modeling, where, four or five guys would ascend onto a model and begin planing and scraping and sanding and sculpting, literally sculpting with their hands. And that's what, of course, Italy is so well known for, these artists and craftsmen.
Mio padre diceva sempre che all'inizio c'è solo l'uomo con la propria anima, con la propria professionalità e il proprio pensiero. Ed è da questo che è nato ogni progetto legato al design di Bertone.
Today we're doing that in the computer. We're using points in space, and we have to really study that section, just as once upon a time they used to draft these things full scale. I mean, they literally used to take ship curves, and they used to create a full scale, what they call a piano di forma, which is the four view, classical architectural view, of a geometric view of the object. So in that case, you'd have a side view, you'd have a top view, a front view, and a rear view. And they would literally do it full scale. So they take these gigantic curves, and they literally plot and draw with a pencil the car. Now today, we do that all on the computer.
Bertone is 10 years into its investment in emerging markets like China. Clearly, there's a tremendous opportunity to reclaim Bertone's greatness as part of being a design on lots of disciplines and lots of markets. What does this car kind of represent in that context?
This company, Stile Bertone, is at a turning point. Dr. Gaudio has set forth a new business plan, and this is, let's say, the first fruits of our labor that people will really see and be able to touch and feel and interact with. This is kind of our mission statement in saying that we're here, we're back, we want to do avant-garde, provocative work. We want to be your sparring partner. We want to help you develop your brands. Our homework is different depending on whether it's for our established clients. What does this mean? You know, we understand that we're not going to be probably fixing the Steely Bertone name to the side of your cars because, let's face it, the world has changed. Large car companies have invested hundreds of millions of euros of dollars into creating their own center styles. They have hundreds of designers, computer modelers, physical modelers. It's becoming a moment of insourcing. We chose the auto show we chose for a reason, because that's where our core is. That's where our real homework is. And there, it's a very different homework assignment than what we used to have. You know, there we're really going to once again do what these companies did 50 years ago with these established European and American companies and Japanese companies, and build brands from zero. You know, there's a tremendous moment going on in the emerging markets.